One of the worst pain points in investing is when you realize you've been deceived. In the world of property investing, that happens when you find out that the land title you are holding is a fake.
We have with us today Ronald Ortile, Deputy Administrator of the Land Registration Authority, to tell us about how to avoid being victimized by fake property titles. Good day, Dep. Ronnie.
Hi, good day.
Hello.
Hello.
Good to see you finally. So
yes,
we have you here, and we want really to go right into the discussion contained on how significant is this problem of land title scams?
Well, at this point in time where we have already engaged a project proponent, contractor in building our computerization project, I could say that we have already managed this prevalence of fake titles. We have already instituted many procedures to avoid being duped by criminals, and syndicates. And so, but there are still cases involving fake titles.
Before, this was a huge problem, when the LRA and the other government authorities, even the local government units, when there was no computerization yet.
Yes, because basically, the reason why it's very easy to fake titles because titles are made of paper.
Mm-hmm.
So just like any other document, it can be duplicated and copied.
Right.
So Dep. Ronnie, if you think about it, this is one of the biggest, if not the biggest, purchase of anybody from
BMW
or consumer, lifelong dream to have.
Probably the biggest investment in
Absolutely.
Their life.
So all the more people have to be circumspect about the titles.
Right.
Tell me about what is it in the new system that allows you to distinguish between a fraudulent document and the real one?
Okay. Well, our computerization project, which we call the Land Titling Computerization Project, or the LTCP, includes many features, and one of which is the conversion of existing titles to digital format.
That's a lot, no?
And then on top of that, we already transitioned to issuing new titles in electronic form.
Okay.
Whereas before, both the original copy and the owner's copy are both physical. Whereas now, when you buy a property and you issue a new title, it is now in electronic form. The old original copy, which is stored in the registry, is now in digital format. There is no more physical paper.
Mm-hmm.
It is now stored still in the register of deeds concerned, but stored in the database,
in
the servers. What is now issued physically are merely the owner's copies, which is then delivered to the owner. So unlike before, when there are two physical documents prepared, one kept in the registry, the other issued to the owner, now the original copy is now in digital form. There's no more paper. It's now in digital format. And the owner's duplicate is the one left physical and issued to the owner.
There are a lot of implications,
sure,
I suppose.
Absolutely.
Yes.
You've got a base there already in terms of cross-referencing to the original, but is it also now that you make it accessible for anybody who wants to inspect the validity of a title?
The accessibility has been there ever since, you simply go to the RD, file a request, and for example, you want to obtain a certified true copy of a title, then you lodge a request. But before, when we were not yet computerized, all the research, the search, and the generation of the certified true copy are all done manually.
Yes. That's
so
crazy.
If, for example, for some reason, the vault keeper or the records officer is not feeling well or is absent, then you would have to wait for them to be up and about and or present so that they can search for the original copy upon which the certified true copy
will be
based.
So about speed of access also.
But now, because the system...
Ease and speed.
Yes, yeah. It's now in the database. When you lodge a request, that will not anymore be a factor in securing the certified copy because it's now in the database.
This is going to solve also the problem of what used to be a big problem before, when the records are destroyed by fire or flood,
etc. That's true.
And you don't have a classic backup because that's a physical
A classic
document.
Example is Quezon City. Before, the Register of Deeds of Quezon City was housed in the Quezon City Hall, the basement. And a fire occurred in City Hall, not in the registry, in 1988. And so, including the fire, was the Registry of Deeds of Quezon City. And most, if not great majority of the titles were burned.
And that's and the cost of some scams also, no?
Yes,
because of a missing thing, you can replicate that easily, right?
The law allows administrative reconstitution as, because ordinarily the remedy would be judicial reconstitution. But under law RA 26, if there is if the minimum requirement is met, the aggrieved party can avail of administrative reconstitution. That is where the problem happens.
That's where the intervention can come
yes.
in also.
Sometimes many scammers yeah. pretending to be the owners were the ones who filed the reconstitution petition.
Putting their names
they can
in
sell
there, yeah.
that property as
yes.
if they're the ones who own
and
it.
So they're pretending to be the owners, and in the process, you know, there are many things happen. Reconstituted titles are issued to not the real owners.
Mm-mm. How do you solve that now?
Well, again, computerization.
Mm-hmm. But those who bought before, and they're the real owners, right? And they're
well, they can always file a case in court for mm-hmm. Annulment or cancellation of the reconstituted titles okay. that were issued to not the real owners. Mm-hmm. And they can always present evidence showing that we are the real owners.
So you talk about recourse here for somebody who already has a title, but for example, like me, if a land buyer, for example, I bought land recently. Mm-hmm. One of the pieces of advice I was given is to look at any annotations on the back of the title. How do you do that if it's computerized? Because a lot of these liens and encumbrances are usually annotated on the title
right,
itself.
Right.
How does it work on a computerized system?
Okay, before we go there, I'd like to explain first the nature and significance of the liens and encumbrances. At the back of the title, whether it's a manually issued one or an electronic, there's always a page where encumbrances are made, yeah. are annotated. And this is where you annotate transactions, be it a voluntary transaction like a deed of mortgage or a lease contract or a special power of attorney and the like. Or involuntary ones like an affidavit of adverse claim mm-hmm. or a notice of dispendence.
So those are the red flags, mm-hmm. right? Yeah.
Yes. And the difference there is that involuntary transactions, you need to present the owner's duplicate mm. because the transaction involved an agreement between the parties. Whereas an involuntary transaction does not involve or necessitate the surrender of the owner's duplicate. Because, for example, in your example, someone was able to cause the reconstitution of my title.
Yeah.
Then I can file a case against you, mm-hmm. and I can now cause the annotation of a notice of lease pendence, meaning a pending case
yes. mm-hmm.
on your title. Mm-hmm. And I don't need to present your owner's duplicate to have my notice of lease pendence annotated
mm-hmm.
on your title because uh-huh. it's an involuntary one.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Necessarily, you will not definitely
yes.
surrender
yes.
your owner's duplicate. But then again, the memorandum of encumbrances on the title is where the public can see whether there are or there exists liens or encumbrances on the title so that you'll be informed in case you want to buy, oh, it's mortgage.
Mm-mm.
Oh, there's an adverse claim by another
yeah.
person. So you will more or less get an idea as to whether you will proceed
yeah.
with the sale
or
yeah.
not. But before you even go there, you need to determine with certainty whether there is actually such a title
that's right.
registered
how do you do that?
In that name and actually covers a particular parcel of land.
Yes.
Is that possibly done via the internet now with the LRA?
What you can do actually is it's the banks now where we have an extension office mm-hmm. that gives them the capability to generate certified true copies of titles in our database of titles located
anywhere
in the country.
Any chance now, of that being opened up to
the public? Yes.
Because if I'm an
have,
OFW and I'm looking at
the ongoing projects right now where you can actually lodge the request for certified true copy and pay mm-hmm. using cashless payment schemes mm. and then you can either pick it up from the RD or have it couriered to you.
Mm-hmm.
So in a few months, we will be able to launch that service.
Now, physically, when you're looking at the title,
yeah.
you want our viewers to know how to determine.
Okay, going back. Someone offers you a property
right.
and you're on the lookout for a property to buy. For example, you're an OFW and someone offers you property and it's titled. So he shows you the title or a certified true copy of the title, purported to be a certified true copy. First thing you should do is, well, preferably if you know the person, that's good. If you don't know the person,
not even I don't think in the Philippines sometimes.
This is a KYC.
Yeah. If you don't know the person, request for a copy of the title, and then go to the RD concerned, and request for a certified true copy, not the one that was shown by the seller.
So you can see if it matches or if there's discrepancy.
Yes, because if you're able to secure a certified true copy of that on your own from the register of deeds and compare it with the one shown to you and it looks the same, you've passed the first test, which means that yes, there is such a title with this number registered in that name describing a particular parcel of land located in that area with that size. So next is to go to the site.
You have to verify physically.
Yes.
That's a big problem with overseas Filipino workers who invest it, because a lot of them don't have the capacity nor the time to physically verify. So if the title itself, the only thing that you're holding is the title itself, are there signs that some of these might be fake?
Well, even before you even make the first payment, you must first meet those due diligence requirements.
Sure.
No? Because you should not part with your money without being sure that actually, you've checked the title, you've checked. After that, you have to request also the seller, and I don't think he or she should refuse that. If the seller can accompany you to the Register of Deeds office so that you can check personally from the Register of Deeds officer as to the authenticity of the owner's duplicate being presented to you.
But these have security.
They have security features.
Features, no?
But
the document itself.
Those are for preliminary purposes, no? So that you may, at the first instance, check if these are genuine. The manually issued ones, as distinguished from the electronic titles, from 1984 up, were issued by the Banco Central ng Pilipinas.
Right.
And these are the red bordered ones with the kind of yellowish colored with red bordered with red borders. And they have security features like intaglio, how do you describe that?
So you give it a seal, and then you've got this.
There's the seal, and then there's planchettes.
Yes.
And then there's fibers, just like money.
Just like money.
Yes.
So there's a texture to it.
There is also a texture to that.
No,
but if you're not accustomed to handling titles, you will not be able to distinguish between a genuine and a fake one, because I've seen fake ones. Spurious ones.
They really look real.
Really?
Almost down
to the
last
degree. If you're not an expert,
yeah.
You will be duped into believing that they are genuine ones. Right now, for you to be able to get an electronic title, there must be a transaction that results in the issuance of a new title. Example, you buy a property, a sale, or an extrajudicial settlement of estate, or a donation. All of these involves the cancellation of the existing one and the issuance of a new one. The new ones will now be automatically in electronic form. But what about those titles that you're not intending to sell? Where, for example, where your ancestral home stands. You can actually avail of our program of voluntary upgrade.
Is the computerization project finished already?
Well,
all over the country, all the titles.
Speaking, we're about 99% done.
Wow.
And in terms of transaction processing, we are already processing 99% of all transactions nationwide using the system designed by our project proponent under the LTCP.
To me, that's a big deal.
Absolutely.
I mean, every time there's computerization, you take out scammers.
Discretion,
you take out everyone who wants to deceive somebody.
As of now, we have around still remaining 11 million nationwide active manually issued titles. We need to upgrade this to electronic ones, because if the universe of all active titles in the country are now electronic, it will like be like it will have a domino effect as to benefit, like faster processing. The law on reconstitution will virtually become functus officio, meaning it would have no more use because
you've migrated those titles
in
the base.
There are no more titles in the registry that will be lost or destroyed because these are already
centralized already.
Digital,
digital or electronic already, and hopefully these are secure. But 11 million is what percentage of the total universe?
I figure around maybe 3 million. 3 million are now
already migrated
e-titles. Yes.
Oh, okay. That's a big amount. 11 million versus 3 million.
But hopefully you reach a point of no return where this transparency and compliance can come.
Actually, it's actually mandatory.
Let's pray for that. It's under the law.
It's actually mandatory. We issued a circular mandating a three-year period within which to cause the upgrade.
And the three-year period ends.
And next year.
That's amazing. Thank you so much for your time, Deputy.
You're welcome.